You are listening to Daily Bread Devotions with Father Eustace Siame, a Salesian of Don Bosco. Your word, Lord, is a lamp for my steps. Stay tuned.
This is my daily bread. This is my daily bread. Your very word spoken to me.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
It is Monday, the 10th of January, 2022, first week in ordinary time. And today we have the following Daily Bread members taking part in the proclamation of the word. Doreen Umuhire, taking the first reading, who celebrates also her birthday today. Child of Christine Naimana Nsanje from Lilongwe, Malawi. And taking the responsorial psalm is Kayla Taonga Nyirongo, child of Leonard and Mwansa Nyirongo from Ndola, Zambia. And proclaiming the gospel is Father Henry Rikingi, a Komboni missionary working in Kisangani, Democratic Republic of Congo. Let us pray. Attend to the pleas of your people with heavenly care, O Lord, we pray, that they may see what must be done and gain strength to do what they have seen. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen.
First reading. Her rivals provoke Hannah sorrowfully because the road had crossed her womb. The beginning of the first book of Samuel. 1 Samuel chapter 1 verse 1 to 8. There was a certain man of Ramath Zophim of the hill country of Ephraim, whose name was Elkanah, the son of Jeroham, son of Elihu, son of Tohu, son of Zoph, an Ephraimite. He had two wives. The name of the one was Hannah, and the name of the other Peninnah. And Peninnah had children, but Hannah and no children. Now this man used to go up year by year from his city to worship and to sacrifice to the Lord of hosts at Shiloh, where the two sons of Eli, Hophni and Phinehas, were priests of the Lord. On the day when Elkanah sacrificed, he would give portions to Peninnah his wife and to all her sons and daughters. And although he loved Hannah, he would give Hannah only one portion because the road had crossed her womb, and her rival used to provoke her sorrowfully to irritate her because the road had crossed her womb. So it went on year by year. As often as she went up to the house of the road, she used to provoke her. Therefore, Hannah wept and would not eat. And Elkanah, her husband, said to her, "Hannah, why do you weep? And why do you not eat? And why is your heart sad? Am I not more to you than 10 sons, the weight of the rod?"
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. Psalms 116, 12 to 13, 14 and 17, 18 to 19. Response. A thanksgiving sacrifice I make to you, O Lord. How can I repay the Lord for his goodness to me? The cup of salvation I will raise. I will call on the name of the Lord. Response.
A thanksgiving sacrifice I make to you, O Lord.
My vows to the Lord I will fulfill before all his people. A thanksgiving sacrifice I make. I will call on the name of the Lord. Response.
A thanksgiving sacrifice I make to you, O Lord.
My vows to the Lord I will fulfill before all his people, in the courts of the house of the Lord, in the midst of Jerusalem. Response.
A thanksgiving sacrifice I make to you, O Lord.
Repent and believe in the gospel. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Mark chapter 1, verses 14 to 20. After John was arrested, Jesus came into Galilee, preaching the gospel of God and saying, "The time is fulfilled, and the kingdom of God is at hand. Repent and believe in the gospel." And passing along by the Sea of Galilee, he saw Simon and Andrew, the brother of Simon, casting a net in the sea, for they were fishermen. And Jesus said to them, "Follow me, and I will make you become fishers of men." And immediately they left their nets and followed him. And going a little further, he saw James, the son of Zebedee, and John, his brother, who were in their boat mending the nets. And immediately he called them, and they left their father Zebedee in the boat with the hired servant and followed him. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
We have begun the ordinary time with the book of Samuel. And Samuel is going to guide us in this month of January up to the 1st of February. So we are dealing with Samuel in the weekdays from today until the 1st of February. Apart from when we will be having any feast, that is the conversion of St. Paul, and whatever feast we may have in between, we are going to focus on the book of Samuel. And so it is good, as we do, to have the background of this book of Samuel, Samuel 1 and 2, because there are two books here. The author or the authors of 1st and 2nd Samuel are not known. These books recount the stories of Samuel, Saul, and David. We know very well that Saul's reign began between 1050 to 1030 BC and ended in 1010 BC. David then took over and reigned until 971 BC. The books were probably written after the end of the reign of David. Now, what is the focus of the books of Samuel? The central theme of the books of Samuel is how the Lord established a dynasty, that is a house, in Israel for David rather than Saul, and how he chose Jerusalem as the place where David's successor would establish the temple for the worship of the divine king, God himself. The purpose of 1 Samuel is to highlight two major events: the establishment of the monarchy in Israel and the rise of David to the king after Saul. Now, after ruling for a while, Saul was rejected by the Lord in favor of David. Though Saul stayed on the throne until his death at Mount Gilboa. Later, in 2 Samuel chapter 7, God promised David and his house an eternal dynasty. The book of 1 Samuel establishes the principle that obedience to the word of God is the necessary condition for a king to be acceptable to the God of Israel. Obedience to the word of God. Any king, any ruler, anyone in a position of authority must be obedient to the word of God. First and Second Samuel deal with a transitional period in the history of ancient Israel. There is a transition of leadership, first from the priest Eli to the judge Samuel, then from the judge Samuel to the king Saul, and then from Saul to David. Samuel thus is the link between the judgeship and the kingship in Israel. He is the prophet God uses to anoint both Saul and David. The kingdom of Saul was also transitional. Under Saul, Israel was more than a loose confederation that gathered together whenever there was a common threat. But there was no strong central rule such as existed later. The story of the rise of David in the second half of 1 Samuel prepares for the full-scale kingship of David in 2 Samuel. With this background, we are going to journey together to understand the message that is found in 1st and 2nd book of Samuel. We see in the word of God we have begun reading today from the first book of Samuel, the conditions that surrounded the birth of Samuel. We are presented with two women here who were married to Elkanah, that is Peninnah and Hannah. Peninnah had children and Hannah had no child. But what we see is that Elkanah showed a lot of affection to somebody who had no child. And we learn something here that, listen, you may not have a child in your own marriage. As a man, you are supposed to show affection to your beloved wife. You are supposed to show affection to the Hannah that you have. The name Hannah comes from the Hebrew name Chana, which means favor. Favor of God or grace. Despite the fact that she had no child, she had the favor of God. That's why she was the beloved. You may not have a child. You might be going to 50 or you are above 50. But understand this. Despite not having a child, you are the Hannah. You are the favor of God. God will favor you in various ways. It's not a must that you were born to become a mother of a child. That's why the example you see are the nuns that we have in this world. The sisters who are dedicated to serving God. They are very happy without having a child. They are comfortable. I am happy without having a child. I am comfortable. Because what is important is not the biological children that we get, but the many children we get through our spiritual connection. So you may not have any child, but God will favor you by giving you many other children you will connect yourself to spiritually. Hannah went through a lot of challenges. Hannah was ridiculed by Peninnah, but she kept crying to God that God may show his favor. Don't cry to people. Don't cry in front of people. Cry to God. Hannah never stopped going up to the temple to cry to God to seek for his intervention. And we are going to see the outcome. The gospel passage of today tells us about Jesus getting into ministry. John is arrested. After the arresting of John, Jesus gets into business. It's time for me to shine because John had already said he must increase, I must decrease. Now it's time for me to increase. And so he goes to the Sea of Galilee, where the population was quite high, and he called his immediate collaborators. But he started preaching the gospel of repentance. Repent, for the kingdom of God is at hand. The time is fulfilled and the kingdom is at hand. Repent and believe the gospel. If you want the kingdom to be here, not just close, but to be with us, we have to repent and believe in the word of God. We have to change our lives because the kingdom of God is a place where transformation is perfected. And then he calls his immediate collaborators. And it is from this calling that we learn how to repent and believe the gospel. Peter and Andrew, the sons of Zebedee, all responded with immediacy. They responded with urgency in their lives. They did not wait. Some of us would want to delay. No, I will stop this habit later. There are people who will tell me when they see me and, oh, you know what, Father? I really want to commit myself and I think I should just get back to my faith. I think I should just, again, another year would pass. They would tell you the same thing. Another year, they would tell you the same thing. But trans transformation needs a decision maker here. You have to decide, and decision is to be done today, not any other day. We give glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Blessed Monday to you.
Thanks be to God.
This is my daily bread. Your very word spoken to me, and I'm desperate for you. And I'm lost without you. This is the air I breathe. This is the air I breathe. Your bed.